Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are back at OWMBZA. We still have Pasma in the building. We come with the episode 2, whereby they will be telling more about themselves, about the party, about the organization. Trying to make you understand why you should vote for them. They're trying to make sure to make sure that you're making the right choice. Why should you vote for them? All of that, Mr. Pusheng. I'm giving you each and everything that you want to ask, and then it's time for you to take control, Mr. Pusheng.
Yes, thanks again, Owen. Coming to substance, we've been going around asking students what are their views on every political party, right? So one of the major things that they were asking is the image of the party. So in some of the students here, they have a particular image. I would not say what type of image it is, but a particular image of Pasma. A image that sometimes can be, they like to say, they say they don't look like the others, if you, they're like the blue ones. I'll just say that. So what do you guys have to say?
Why should we say the blue ones, Mr. Pusheng? What are you doing?
So how do you guys respond to the image of the party?
Yeah, they didn't catch you.
They didn't catch you. So let me just rephrase. So what they is trying to say is, it is as if they create an image as if Pasma is with people who don't take care of themselves. So that's why they feel like this party is not for me. Because of how they take care of themselves. Or how they think they take care of themselves. Mm-hmm. So how do you guys respond to such things?
What I would say is that people see us as a very peaceful party. And if you check all of us, all of our members, they are very disciplined. We know that comrades drink, Amajunji drink, but it is very rare that you'll find a Pasma member going to a tavern or going to a drinking place with regalia or wearing the t-shirt of the party or cap of the party. They take very good care of themselves. Therefore, and we are also not a party that would use propaganda to derail another party in order to gain more votes. We're a party that goes there and talks about itself, tells students what has the party itself done. What is the party willing to do in order to move the structure forward of the organization?
And also, one of the questions also is, how ready is Pasma? Let me just talk about SRC in general. Are we ready for the women to be a president of any campus? Particularly
in all six TUT campuses.
In all six TUT campuses. Is TUT ready for a female president?
We are more than ready to deliver the in 2015 we had a female president who was from Pasma, and right now it's time to reclaim the glory and once again say train the nation, train the woman, and deliver another woman who will be the president of the campus.
So is it about time that a president of the campuses becomes a woman?
The president general in all six TUT campuses.
It's about time. It's about time.
Yes.
So how can you guys make sure? Or how can you rally other parties? Because it's not about... Because it's been too long. As far as my understanding, we've never had a female president.
Yeah.
So...
Even in South Africa.
What must happen? Are we saying that women are incapable? Are we saying that women are supporting men all the time?
As Pasma.
Yes.
As Pasma, the reason we deployed Pumzile Masego as a woman to SRC is because we wanted to make sure that she's ready to lead. Whether it's campus president or going to institutional SRC, we believe that she's ready and we are ready to deliver a woman.
Okay. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, OWMBZA on Mabuza right now. You can just call us or send us a voice note on WhatsApp, and then we'll make sure that we play the voice note on the next episode of Public Upfront Daily Show. You can hit us on 084-971-9364 and also find us on our email, Mr. owensairlife@gmail.com, on Twitter, owensairlife, on Instagram, Mr. owensairlife. We're also on YouTube. You can subscribe and get all the daily updates on Mr. Owen Mabuza Life live show, and also on Facebook, Mr. Owen Mabuza live show. Find us also on Spotify, Catbox, Google Podcast, and find us also as well in all media platforms where you can find the podcast. Right now, we continue with Pasma in the building. Mr. Pushen, continue.
Also, to pick up from where we left off, imagine I am sitting at Khayetu today, tonight. I'm thinking about waiting tomorrow. Why must I vote for Pasma? Why must I say tomorrow I'm in the ballot? Must I go to Pasma? Kumzeli, what do you have to say?
I believe we're all Africans. And Pasma is an African movement organization. And I believe your vote is your voice. So basically means that tomorrow when you go to the ballot paper and vote. You must make sure that you have your facts correct. Because firstly, you must look at the candidate for SRC for this year, for the upcoming elections. Who do you see is fit to go to SRC? Where is that person? If that person is in Pasma, which means you have to make the right vote. You understand?
Yeah.
So I believe, Hore, when you see the list of candidate of SRC, you must basically know, Hore, what is this structure bringing me? Because you'll find, Hore, there is someone who you know, Hore, is not capable to be a true leader. So you go and vote for that structure. Tomorrow they disappoint you. You come back, you cry. You must make sure you vote for the right structure. In saying so, Pasma has done a lot for the student. I myself have done a lot for a student. I even sacrificed my classes and everything. I can tell you that is not a secret. Even everyone knows. Or Pumzile was not attending last year. I would go to my classmates, go and ask, what did you do in class? Because daily basis, my work last semester was to say, early in the morning, I wake up, I go to building 22. I make sure students have residences. I make sure students are sorted out with everything.
Everything.
I also update on the media.
Yeah.
Which shows, Hore, we are 9 in the council. But who have been with you since day one? You understand? How can you go and vote for someone who didn't care for you? Student needed residence. Student needed NSFAS. Student were appealing. Student were excluded.
They came to you.
Even now.
They know the right person.
They know the right person. So I believe for tomorrow, people will make the right decision.
Yeah.
Because you cannot say, Mina, I'm voting for this thing, for this structure that has not done anything for you. As I said, I'm the PMC. But I chose to be a leader, not to be a PMC. I chose to do everything that student wanted. If you call me and say, Pumzile, we have this problem in our classroom, I'd go and consult with the lecture and the HOD. If you call me and say, I have this problem with my financial aid, I'd go to NSFAS with you and consult with you.
Meaning you know the right people to go to solve the problem.
If you know the campus, you know the right people. Because every office has its bargain. You know our building 22, there's this office and this office. If this person has this kind of a problem, you know where to go to. And also respect. That's also an important thing. Because when you enter those offices, if Unali, we call this thing in this comrades way, anarchy. If you have anarchy, they'll give you anarchy. So you must always humble yourself. So by saying so, Mina, people thought, Hore, Pumzile is part of management, but what I was not. Because where I come from, I was raised up with the respect. And even now, I'm still doing the things that they taught me at home. I know how to fight my battles. I know how to attack people. I know how to attend issues. So, Mina, I'm saying to all students, make the right decision. For your voice.
Okay, from my side, Mr. Mpushen, to take over from you a little bit. From my Mr. Benford said, I have the last question from my side as we are closing. I don't know if you want to close with my question or you close with your own statement, but I prefer that to close with your own statement because this is the campaign you're campaigning for your party. And look, from my side, I say, what are you gonna do differently from the past leadership that has been here on campus?
What we can do differently is that if you check in all six TUT campuses, not just GARANKUWA,
you'll
find that a student is paying for an academic record.
Yeah.
Why do we have to pay for an academic record when you've already paid for fees?
I don't want to pay for academic record.
And also, if you check around, why should you pay for bus fare when you're a student of all six TUT campuses? Why should you pay for bus fare? Again, I'm going to say, why should you pay for remarking? Why should you pay to see your script?
Why should we pay?
Why should you pay to see your script? Just to see if the lecturers made a wrong mistake when marking your paper. Why should you pay? In addition to that, why should students in all accredited residences, why should students pay for staying there when they have re-exams? Why should they pay?
Re-exams should not have any payment.
They should not. They should not. And another thing, if you check around, it is only Pasma that is fighting all those things.
Yeah.
Therefore, we ask all students to make the right choice when voting. You can wear t-shirts of any other structure, but when voting, be conscious.
You know.
Make sure that you vote for the right structure or the right organization. Do not just go there because there's a certain someone that you know in an organization. Be conscious. Know your leaders.
No favors.
No favors. Thank you.
So, Mr. Pushek, take over.
So to end this nice conversation, let's say you win all 10 seats.
All nine
seats. Right? What is your vision? What are you going to do? Let's say tomorrow you win. You get the results that you guys want. What is the first thing that you guys do? What is the first thing that you'd be like, okay, guys, we're doing this?
The first thing that I would do. First thing that we do is that all students who had academic exclusions and financial exclusions are accepted back into the system. That's the first thing. Because you cannot just stay at home because you failed 6 out of 10 modules. Why should you stay at home if you failed 6 out of 10 modules? I mean, I believe in giving people chances. Why should someone not have their fees paid just because they're failing? How well do you know that someone is not having some psychological issues back at home, some family problems? How well do you know that? Why should academic exclusions be there for first-time students, students who are first years? Why should they be academically excluded? Because those students are new. Those students are just new into the campus. Why should they be excluded? Because they are still trying to fit in. They are still trying to find themselves. Why?
Closing up, Mr. Mbushen, let's give Miss Pumzi to close up with the closing up for today, and then let's hear her closing. How is it like, Miss Pumzi? The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, guys, for having us. I would simply say, guys, make the right decision. You know the right decision deep down your heart, and for those who are doing their final year and they're leaving, don't make a decision based on your personal feelings. Make a right decision for the incoming future of this university. Our younger brothers are coming next year. The leaders we choose right now, tomorrow, will be the leaders who will be leading us even next year. So if you choose the wrong leaders this year, it means our student will suffer next year. So make the right decision. Train a woman, train a nation.
Pasma.
Pasma.
Thank you very much, our listeners. Student, TUT GARANKUWA campus, Nizwile, Lebone, what's going to happen on tomorrow. Make the right choice. That's what they say. Make the right choice. Izwele to Pasma. They were here with us. You can give us your voice note and then we'll forward it to the leadership on 084-971-9364. We'll definitely forward the voice note to the leadership and hear what they're saying. I'm closing with J. Cole Change. Thank you very much for joining us and tuning in. OWMBZA on my Buzza Say live show. We are closing up. Mind was telling me that these are the days. Mind was telling me that
my intuition is telling me there'll be better days. Light is tone.
My intuition is telling me there'll be better days. I sit in silence and find whenever I meditate. My fears alleviate, my tears evaporate. My faith don't deviate, ideas don't have a date. But see, I'm growing and getting stronger with every breath, bringing me closer to heaven's doors with every step. As we speak, I'm at peace, no longer scared to die. Most don't believe in God, and so they terrified. It's either that or they be fearing they gon'